This is a moment in which we know there's going to be a paradigm shift. Science right now is on our side.
Ahora mismo son 10 meses que estamos sin luz. Se escuchaban esos vientos, se escuchaban esa lluvia y la gente tan preocupada. Cuando pasó el huracán María, pues que salimos a la calle, vimos una destrucción horrible. Parecía una película de terror. Y eso para mí fue algo bien... No tengo palabras para expresar lo que yo sentía. Estaba de verdad algo bien triste.
The centralized large power plants that Puerto Rico has did not suffer really much damage. So it wasn't a problem of generating the power. It was a matter of transporting that power from the places where it's generated, the large power plants, to the places that people needed it. The impact on the transmission system was so large that basically the blackout lasted for so long, months. Maria really proved that the centralized hierarchical model that has dominated the electric utility industry in Puerto Rico for almost 80 years is insufficient to really deal with the impact hurricanes can have in the island. There's a lesson there. We need to look at more local resources. A microgrid is a geographical area where you have enough electric energy resources so that that area can operate by itself, disconnected from the utility or from other systems. It's also a social approach to deal with the energy challenges in the island. Collaborating with the grid, part of your energy would come from the utility, but part of your energy would also come from your local resources. If the grid is not there because of a storm or whatever, you can still operate as if you were a microgrid.
Mira la plaza pública cuando detuvimos la minería. 10,000 personas.
Casa Pueblo is a community-based organization up in the mountains. In 1999, Casa Pueblo decided to break the energy dependency, and since then we have been running on solar power. We were able to open the house the day after the hurricane. People were coming here to use our installations as an energy oasis to recharge their equipment, to connect their respiratory equipment. Immediately, we were able to deploy a community relief effort.
Just be careful.
And this is our power plant. No air emissions, no pollution. We're using solar power to generate electricity.
That solar panel is made of a special material or materials that basically take the energy from the light of the sun and makes the material within that solar panel create that electricity flow.
100% of the energy at this point is coming from solar power. Some energy is going back to the batteries, but the batteries are already full. We want to export that excess energy to our neighbors. So that's the future.
When we came here, we realized that this was a paramount moment in the history of our country. Technology is going to change it, but people are going to drive that technology. This is one of the places we came at the very beginning, 1 month after Maria, to Jayuya. Community started organizing and began talking about the kind of system they wanted to deploy in their own community. So there were some donations, small system. The people at the beginning, they were afraid of doing it by themselves. But by the second week, the people were installing system by themselves.
Dale, dale, no. Dale.
No están poniendo las placas solares. Mi papá, él tiene glaucoma avanzado. Mi mamá tiene demencia. Y es bien importante para ellos tener esa luz, pues que tengan su televisor prendido, su bombillita, la nevera que le esté funcionando.
We are not talking now about building microgrids from zero. We are talking about how can we start deploying very small systems that will be used in emergency and from that microgrid from the community.
Maximizing our local energy resources, the sun, the wind, the ocean where technology is available, but also us, the main player here, the main component is the people.
The electrical system of the country is going to build from the ground up. It's going to be built by the grassroots. It's going to be built by the own people, bit by bit. In the century of climate change, renewable, distributed energy is the kind of technology that can let the people own their energy.
We have to move away from centralized power generation. We are generating electricity at the point of consumption, and that's what we call resiliency.